Morning, dear students. Today, we are starting physics syllabus. In the physics, we are going to discuss the chapter magnetism and matter. Okay. Our present topic is magnetism and matter. Okay. What are the basic concepts in this meeting? We are going to study about magnets, okay, and magnetic fields. So, mainly the first basic topic what we are going to discuss is magnets. Secondly, magnetic field. And next, behavior of magnets. In the field mean magnetic field. In the field mean magnetic field. Okay. Like that, these are the topics we are going to discuss, and afterwards types of magnetic materials. Types of magnetic materials. And next, afterwards, we are going to discuss about hybrid of oscillating magnets. Okay. Okay. And afterwards, the main topic what we are going to discuss is the parameter. So far, terrestrial magnetism also called geomagnetism. These are the topics covering the future under this chapter. Okay, so please note down first step, and thereafter I will go to discuss all these one by one. In this terrestrial magnetism, mainly we are talking about elements of elements of earth magnetism. That is the meaning of terrestrial magnetism. We are studying about earth magnetism. That is the meaning of this. Okay. Geomagnetism. This is geomagnetism. So, note down where all this. Now we are going to study about first magnets. What are magnets? All those things we are going to discuss about the magnet. Well, discussion we will have in this. Okay, see that. First of all, what is a magnet? The fundamental definition of a magnet. How can we say me? This is a material which are exhibiting three properties. Okay. Normally, magnet is nothing but a solid formula. So, this is a material which exhibits three properties. Not only solid form, actually liquid solid form also available. But basically, most of the magnets are available in solid form, and that it is a material, okay, composition of particles. That material which exhibits three properties. Like, what are the properties to be exhibited by a material to call it as a magnet? First one, attractive property. What is the first one? Attractive property. Second one, inductive property. Third one, directional property. three properties exhibited by any material. That material we can call it as what? A magnet. Okay. So that is the definition of a magnet. What is the basic reason? Actually, what is the meaning of this attractive property? No, well, whenever we place any iron or steel in the vicinity of magnets, what it does? It attracts them by using the magnetism in that steel. So basically, whenever iron piece was placed nearer to that magnet, this magnet attracts it just by inducing magnetism in that. By that, these two properties are simultaneously taking place at that moment. Okay. And what about the third one? Inductive induction production. Production of magnetism in the material, whatever you place nearer to that. For example, if you take an iron and place it nearer to magnets, what it does? It induces the magnetism in opposite direction and it attracts it. Okay. So like that, inductive property is production of magnetism or induction of magnetism. Okay. Next. What is the directional property? You know well, the people, those who are traveling in the ships, how to know the direction by them? They are using compass needle, magnetic compass needle. You know well, magnetic compass needle. How it will be? Simply it having a magnetic needle, so called small magnet is there, mark as north and south. Okay. Always it can show the direction also. So that means whenever we align suspended a magnet, okay, whenever a magnet suspended from a rigid support with the help of a spring, what happens? It aligns in the direction of north south. Automatically it will align in that direction. Why? Because if it is a north pole and it is a south pole, north pole seeking north side, south pole seeking south side. Okay. So by that it always showing particular direction. Due to that reason, we are using this magnet as magnetic compass needle. We are using it as a magnetic compass needle. Okay. Always shows north south direction. I have shown in the diagram. Okay. But one thing here, there is maybe some ambiguity here. Whenever this magnet shows north direction this way, north pole seeking north side and south pole seeking south, geographical south. Is there any contradiction in hearing that? There is contradiction. Normally, according to law of magnetism, like poles are repel, unlike poles are attract. But here, why geographical south attracts the south pole? Why geographical north attracting the north pole? Because see here, if it is a globe and if you have placed a compass needle here, over there we are using compass needle like this. But do remember, earth is said to be having magnets, because earth is not really having, earth is said to be consisted magnetism. So what is the reason in having the magnetism? By the under the ground there are so many minerals in a molten state, that minerals they are floating from one place to another place under the ground. Due to that, most of molten minerals, charge is moving. Whenever charge is moving or accelerating, there is induction of magnetism. Due to that reason, for the earth there is a magnetism. There is a magnetism. By that, do remember, if it is a globe, it is geographical north, it is geographical south. then do remember further the magnet is a present. So if we have imagined a huge giant bar magnet inside the earth, that magnet what we are imagining will be like this. The magnet what we are imagining like this. That happens south pole this side, north pole on the geographical south side. In the opposite way. By that over the earth, for example, if it is a magnet, so called this. When I suspended it over the earth, normally south side which pole having underground, south side, north pole is, and on the north side, south pole is. Then, that north pole attracts south one, by that it seems to be on the south side. And this side is actually geographical north, then underground geographical south pole is. South pole attracts what? North pole. South pole attracts north pole. By the north is sinking north side, geographical north side. Like that, here in showing the directions like this. That is the reason. Whenever a magnet suspended freely, always it can show a particular direction. Okay? Due to that reason, that material is exhibiting or possessing the property directional property. And I told you what is the reason in showing that a particular direction here. And south pole of the suspended magnet always towards south side, north pole towards north side. Okay. By that we can know the direction of directions to travel in the forest as well as in the oceans. Okay. So anyhow, this is the definition of magnet. A magnet being one material which exhibits three properties, like attractive property, inductive property, directional property. And the law of magnetism, what it says, like poles repel, unlike poles attracts. But I did not discuss even pole also, but I will tell you next. Anyhow, in explaining this point to be raised here, okay. So, according to that law of magnetism, like poles are repelled, unlike poles are attracted, okay. Unlike poles are attracted. Do remember it well. Anyhow, I am going to discuss about magnetic pole. A magnet consists of what? Okay. What is the structure of that? What and what are presented in that? Those were the things. But before that, I want to tell you cause. What is the cause of magnetism? In any material, that we are going to see. Do remember, normally any material consists of what? Particles. Particles consist of molecules. Molecules are composition of what? Atoms. Inside the atoms, what are presented? At the central portion of that atom, there is a strong dense ball of positive charge called nucleus. And around that electrons are evolving in particular orbits. Okay. Already you studied this atomic structure well in the first year chemistry. Even in second year also we are going to study it again in physics. So like that, every material consists of what? Matter. Matter is a composition of what? Particles. Particles are the composition of what? Molecules. Molecules are composition of what? Atoms. And that atoms consisted of what? These atoms, for example, it is called a central portion, so called strong dense ball of positive charge. High dense body weight. So Socrates in place. Around that nucleus, electrons are evolving in these orbits. In particular orbits only, electrons are not presented in all orbits. They are presented in particular orbits. In which orbit they are presented in? In the orbits in which the angular momentum of rotating electron equal to n times of h cut. N times of h cut. H cut means that already studied in chemistry. Okay. That means angular momentum equal to n times of h cut. In which orbit this condition has to be obeyed. In that orbit electrons will present. H cut means nothing is the new one here. H cut means h by 2 pi. H cut means what here? H by 2 pi. Okay? So, anyhow, whenever in this diagram I am drawing magnified diagram, it is called a nucleus. And electron wire revolving here with particular velocity. With particular velocity. That experiencing two forces. One is what here? Centripetal force. What is that centripetal force? Electrostatic force. That is the force between nucleus and electron. Okay. That force is called centripetal force. As well as centrifugal force also there. That is mv square by r. Okay. Like that. Start over here, pseudo force. Like that, whenever electrons are evolving in the center path, due to this real force, there is an acceleration for this electron. Okay, like that, any charge if it gets accelerating, what will happen? Magnetism induced. That is the basic principle of electromagnetic induction. By that, when electron moving here, what happens? Current induced. And due to that flow of current in that orbit, there is production of magnetism. Okay? As well as magnetic movement will be there. That is the main cause of magnetism in any material. Do remember. Whenever electron evolving like this, current carries toward opposite to motion of electron. At that moment, what about the B direction at center? B direction at center, current flows in this direction, in opposite direction. Then B direction is inward. B direction what here? Inward. That is B means magnetic field, sorry. So, magnetic field direction so far B means magnetic field index. That direction is inwardly presented here. Like that, due to most of single electron magnetic field induced. Like that, some trillions of electrons are revolving in the materials. You know. By that, materials are simply having magnetism. But in some of the materials, that net magnetic moment, whatever induced, is maybe zero. Those are non-magnetic materials. Okay. And in some materials, that induced magnetic field will be in a moderate level. So that materials can attract another materials feebly. Feebly means not with much force. Okay. They can attract with a medium force. That attraction is called feebly attraction. And the material, in someone, that induced magnetic induction or magnetic moment will be in an appreciable way. At that moment, that materials can attract another materials in a strong way with more strength of force. Such materials are called ferromagnetic materials. What we call them? Ferromagnetic materials. Okay? Like that. The basic cause of magnetism is this one. Do remember it. If anybody asks you what is the cause of magnetism in the magnet. Then immediately you have to tell you the basic principle behind that is electromagnetic indexing. Okay, according to that, whenever electrons are evolving around the nucleus, there is induction of magnetism, okay, or magnetic movement in particular direction to the plane of rotation. That means, see here, if it is a plane of rotation, what is the direction of induced field direction here? Perpendicular to lambda, I told you. It is in inward direction. It is in inward direction. That means that is perpendicular to the plane in which that electron is evolved. Not only B bar, M bar also. M mean magnetic moment. Okay, that magnetic moment also will be in perpendicular plane of rotation of electron. For example, electron revolving like this. Then moment direction in this direction. Okay, that is perpendicular to the plane of rotation of electron. But maybe either in upward direction or in downward direction, that is are going to study in the chapter next time, moving charges and magnetism chapter. Okay, here we are going to say all these things elaborated. Okay, so this is the cause of magnetism. Please note down them. Now let's see fundamentals of magnetism. What is magnet and types of magnets? And what it consisted? Everything we are going to discuss. Already I discussed about magnet. Magnets are basically two types. One is bar magnets. What we call it as bar magnets. Okay. And another one is the horseshoe magnet, that will be like this. Okay. But every magnet consisted what? Inside of them, there are two points at which their attractive power has to be located. That points are called poles. These are called magnetic poles. What we call them? Magnetic poles mean point at which attractive power located. Okay. And there you are seeing the poles. I did not located them exactly at the ends. Where I have located? Just inside the material. Here also. It is a little bit inside from the end or edge. Okay. And these two poles are actually, one is north pole, another one is south pole. Why? Because already I told you, whenever a magnet suspended freely, the pole whichever seeking the north side called north pole, and the pole which is seeking south side is called as south pole. Like that, every magnet consisted how many poles here? Two poles. So by that, this is called north pole, this is called south pole. Similarly, this magnet also consisted of two poles, north pole and south pole. Okay, next definition must be known here is geographical length. What is that instrument? Geographical length. called geometrical lens. So this is called geometrical lens. Okay, so geometrical lens means the total length between two edges of a magnet. Okay, next, the next definition must know is magnetic length. Normally it's represented with the letter 2L. Okay, it's represented with one letter 2L. What is a magnetic length mean? They are located within the magnet at a certain distance. Then, the shortest distance between two magnetic poles is called magnetic length. Okay, so magnetic length means the shortest distance between two magnetic poles of a magnet. Even for this also, geographical length means from here to here. Here to at this edge. And magnetic length means distance, the shortest distance between north pole and south pole. This is called magnetic length, this is called geographical length. Similarly, for this, magnetic length means distance between two magnetic poles. This is magnetic length. Okay. Normally magnetic length are represented with letter L. Okay. Therefore, it is greater. Obviously, geometrical length is greater than magnetic length. What is the relation between them? Do remember, geometrical length is equal to 6 by 5 times of magnetic length. 6 by 5 times of magnetic length. And this magnetic length, we are treated as vector here. So, that is the direction what we are meaning from south pole to north pole. From south pole to north pole. What is SI unit for this? Either geometrical length or magnetic length. SI unit is a meter. What is the series unit? Centimeter. What is the dimensional formula? Dimensional formula. Okay. So these are the definitions regarding poles. Okay, it is magnetic length and geographical length and that. The next definition must know is pole strength. Clearly there is a meaning in this. Heading itself only. What is the meaning of it? Pole strength. That means the strength with which a pole can attract or repel another pole. Okay, the strength. Of a pole. Or the strength with which a pole can attract or repel another pole. Okay? That is called pole strength. What we call it as pole strength. That's normally represented with small m. What is that series unit mean? Ampere, centimeter. And what is the dimensional formula mean? IL. Okay. I mean current. Electrical current. L mean length. So ampere meter. Current length. A product gives you what here? Pole square. So this is a description about pole strength, to remember it well. Okay. It is a pole strength, geographical line, magnetic line, and magnet insisted what and what here. And mainly the point we remember regarding these poles are isolated poles are not existed in the universe. Okay. Main important point what here? Important point here. Isolated poles do not exist in the universe. That means, whatever the magnet size you do, even though you take in micron size or nano size of magnets, it must to consist of two poles. Single pole do not exist. For example, this magnet is there. If you cut down this one into two parts by bisecting into two parts, we are getting two pieces. We are getting two pieces. In cutting them, here magnetic connection has to place. Then this north pole is easily presented as north pole.